Hey guys, I'm Chris Hickson. This is QB Talk, powered by QBIQ, of course, and I've got a great one here for you today. Marist High School, the program, the standard of programs. I got the quarterback, Connor Sigelski. What's up, man?
Oh, not too much. I'm just excited to be here. How you doing?
Well, I know why you're excited. You're still alive in the playoffs, which is awesome. You guys are 10-2, right?
Yes, sir.
Who do you guys got this week?
Mary Persons.
Now, before we get into them and what that looks like, game plan and everything, I want to know a little bit. You guys are 10-2. You guys are a factory for wins, right?
Yes, sir.
What is the secret ingredients over at Marist?
Coach Alan Chadwick, of course. I mean, he's just an all-around great guy, great head coach, and he's been running that option for years.
How many wins? Now, this will freak you guys out a little bit. How many wins does he have?
357.
I was about to say, that's the most of all time ever. He started when he was 10. So, but he's got 370-something wins, right? And that puts him number two in Georgia, behind a coach from Valdosta, right?
I think so.
And I think he's only got a few more to go to eclipse that. But talking about this year, and what's been the secret sauce? Because I think you're a different team than last year, right? You're a different team, I think.
We're much younger this year, much more experienced. But I feel like that affected us early in the year. But now we've all started to grow up, and I think that we're starting to mature. And, like, I mean, I think we're sort of a different team, but down to, like, the core roots, we're all the same thing. It's just about, like, getting wins, you know?
Speaking young, he's a junior this year. Plus, he's got a huge arm. Throws for about 68, 70 yards, big arm. So, but you guys, like you said, you guys are young. And you started off a little slow. You guys had a loss to St. Pius.
That's right.
There's another record in there.
One
that Coach Chadwick's not like. He's not going to like me saying. But in the first time in 72 years, you guys didn't score any points. So what was – now that's kind of your own wallpaper. You know how you sit there and you put something up on the wall and say, that's never going to happen again, or this team said that. Did you guys use that as any kind of gas?
Well, we played them last week, and, I mean, we did. Certainly, they were talking smack, like, all leading up to the week and all throughout the year. We just wanted to go out and prove that it was a fluke. You know, we went and we put up 24 points, and our great defense got the job done, and we walked out there with a win.
I like the way you said that with a lot of confidence, number one. Number two is, talk a little bit about that rivalry. That rivalry is special, because there's nothing like that type of rivalry, the one between you guys and St. Pius. What's that like on game week?
We each hate each other. Each of our schools call it Hay Week, and I mean, it's just, we go out there and we get after it.
I love it, man. That's, you guys know, college teams and rivalry week, it's like that for them. So, all right, well, let's talk a little bit more about you and quarterback position. When did you know you were a quarterback?
I really didn't know until I went to Marist. Like leading up to my years before that, I knew that I was just a kid who had a big arm. I was pretty much a running back, just catch the ball and do whatever I want. But then when I moved over to Marist, they kind of put me a quarterback and I just stuck.
Hey, what's funny is when we were working a little bit, eighth grade and freshman year, I was like, this kid's not very fast. What's going on? Something happened between freshman year and sophomore year. Next thing you know, you're in the state, you know, running for the 100 meter.
Yeah.
What happened?
I don't know.
Start rubbing your thighs with milk or something?
Nah, I should try that though. Started running track, and I guess just getting out there every day and just, like, developing good form and just going out there and getting after it, you know?
Next thing you know, you're in the state, you know, running for the 100 meter. What happened?
I don't know.
Start rubbing your thighs with milk or something?
Nah, I should try that though. Started running track, and I guess just getting out there every day and just, like, developing good form and just going out there and getting after it, you know?
Well, that's awesome. So you didn't know until you kind of got to Marist. And I'm going to tell you something. I've really appreciated the progress you've made at the quarterback position. Probably more so than anything, your leadership.
So
that has been the biggest improvement I've seen. Let's talk about Mary Persons. What do they look like? That's who they're playing this week in the playoffs.
They're pretty good. They're a typical team that Marist beats. They're way more athletic than us, but we're going to be way more coached, and we have a great game plan that's been put in place. And I think we're just going to go out there, and I think we're going to beat them. We're going to be fine.
Well, it starts with a plan, doesn't it?
It does.
Things don't happen by lightning strikes. So you guys start with a plan, and you go about working that plan to make sure you fine-tune it, ready for the game. And then if you know anybody like Chadwick, he's going to have his team ready to play. And guys, listen, I appreciate you stopping by. That pretty much wraps us up for QB Talk. Listen, for QBIQ, what this bad boy is powered by, make sure you check out the system at QBIQSystem.com or follow us on social media, QBIQ System. right here on the B2C stages. We appreciate that. We'll be back at you with QB Talk.